Hey, what is up, guys? Right now, I'm getting ready for my workout. I just wanted to show you my go-to supplements for prep. Right now, it's BCAs, unflavored from Body Logics and Gorilla Jacks.
And I've also got
my glutamine. All Max, also Gorilla Jacks as well. Hit Gorilla Jacks for all your supplements, but these are the two I'm using right now for prep. I'm doing 20 milligrams a day of BCAs, 10 while I work out and 10 during the day, and then 10 of glutamine during the day. So that's what my subs are right now. Also, I really want to talk to you guys a little bit more about just being prepared and being like, if you fail to prepare, you prepare to fail. I've always lived by that motto. That is a great one for myself and for my followers. But what I want to say is that I've gone to the next step. And over the last year, I've really developed a thing for content calendars. Now, me being on Instagram as somewhat of an influencer style person with fitness and a coach and everything, it gets overwhelming trying to plan everything every day as they come for my business, let alone make posts for in the Instagrams and like my YouTube and all stuff. So I have an actual content calendar that I've hired a company. We have gone over all my goals, all of my aspirations for my business, where I want to take it to the next level and keep growing beyond that, and really have a structured platform. So I literally have made a content calendar with this company who has given me a full 366-day calendar. So it's the first day of the next year as well on New Year's, but it gives me from January 1st all the way till January 1st again, so including that day. So what it is it gives me the topics I need to talk about, the things I need to do, and it allows me to go in with confidence and post what we all came up to, a collective agreement with the teamwork, that'll really push my brand, really push my influence to the next level and beyond. What we did is we sat down, we looked at what kind of topics I like to talk about, what kind of things I want my followers to know, what personally they should know to make it feel more genuine, and all these kind of things to bring you guys up to speed and make you more a part out of this, and in the end of the day, make us more of a community. So this calendar seems like a simple idea, but it really helps me. It's way less stress on what I'm trying to post that day. I already have it in mind, so when I go to the gym, I can take content, ideas, and really capture them in the gym days before, so I'm prepared. So it allows me the freedom to continue to do what I'm doing, but with a goal in mind. So if, like today, I'm gonna be posting about my workout routine, and I'm gonna share one of them with you guys. But with that being said, this content calendar is a great idea because basically, guys, the whole reason I got a content calendar in the first place was just because, not that I was super stressed out about it, but it was always a task that took a lot longer than it should, is coming up with creative ideas and motivational ideas and really ideas that'll bring you guys the most value possible. So by sitting down with a company who knows this stuff, and me knowing my followers, me knowing the exact way I want to portray this, the way I want to scale my business, the way I want to grow my brand, they took their knowledge, I took my knowledge, and we met in the middle, and we did a couple weeks of just planning, and we got this beautiful content calendar, which I'm going to show you guys right away, because it's, like, me even talking about it won't do it justice. But this thing is beyond perfect. And honestly, man, I suggest anyone who's entrepreneurial or doing anything that revolves around content, whether it's YouTube, whether it's Instagram, Snapchat, TikTok, any one of these platforms, a content calendar is great. So mine specifically is for more my YouTube, and it's for my Instagram, because those are my main two focuses that I really put the value and content on that matters most, and then I break it down into smaller things, and to touch base on my content as well. What I've been trying to do more is, I learned this from Gary Vaynerchuk. If you don't know who he is, go look his shit up. Entrepreneurial kingpin, need not say more. So, I got this from Gary Vaynerchuk, but what I do is I take my mass piece of content. So say I do a video shoot and I have a 3-minute video, let's just say that. I'll break it down into 1-minute clips for the Reps Up Instagram page, and I'll keep the full video for an IG live on my personal page. And then from those 3-minute clips, I will take other clips that will from that, so like 15 second clips from each one that will go into my story. And from those 15 second clips, I will take screenshots that will become photos later on. As long as they're high quality, yada yada, there's a lot that varies to it, but this is basically how it stems down. So it's a pyramid effect that from your one piece of content, you can essentially turn it into 12, 20, whatever you want from that one piece of content, really stretch it and really bring you guys value from each section, because Let's be honest, nowadays people's attention spans are this big. So by the time they get through the whole video, they probably only retained so much of it, probably only watched part of it, really didn't listen for part of it. So by breaking it down, you can really give the value you're trying to give and send your message and drive it home to your followers and the people who you are connecting with. So this has worked great for me. I suggest anyone who's entrepreneurial or doing any kind of clothing, fitness, content-based stuff, a content calendar would be really great. So what I'm gonna do is go over to my computer here and set it up on the TV. Plus I got the cracked screen because I tripped over the cord and smashed it. So punch in my little password here. And then we're gonna go over here. I'm gonna show you guys this right on my screen right now. Where's the mouse? All right, so what did you see right here on the screen? It's live, hit my content calendar. Is bada bing, bada boom, pow. Nope. But pow, pow, there it is. Okay, so as you can see right up here, we're in the month of February, which the topic is wellness and fitness. So that has been something that's, like, this is all pertaining to me, so your business might be a little bit different, but this is the one we came up with. So it's got everything I need. It talks about, like, we came up with questions that I'd like to ask you guys throughout the year. We come up with monthly topics, personal topics, and a whole bunch of stuff. So let's just take a look at what today would be. So let's go February, what's the date? February 11th. And it says right here, monthly topic, share one of your favorite exercise routines. So today, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be talking to you guys about my favorite fitness exercise routine with a picture of me doing it or however it needs to be, but it gives me a chance prior to this day to go get that picture, to go take it, to go get that video, to create the content days in advance, or almost if I am sparked to do it right now and I have the time, do it rather than a day where I'm super busy and then missing out on it. So this content calendar is great. As you can see down here, it's got all of the months and I just scroll along and it's perfect. So for anybody who's doing anything, I strongly suggest you map it out. Before I made it digital, it was this calendar right here. And you can see a bunch of stuff written in it in pen and scratched out and moved around because it was a nightmare. So now it's a little more structured. I really enjoy it. It's freaking awesome. I don't think I'll ever go back to regular planning because this is just unbelievably simple. It makes me feel more empowered, makes me feel more on top of my game, and honestly just makes your game that much stronger. So you don't have to, but I would suggest it for anyone who does do this kind of shit. Jump on it, man. This is key. This has been a foundation stone for my business. I just wanted to show you guys that because it's fucking awesome. It makes things so much smoother. Like, I plan out so much. I'd say a good like 30% of my business is me planning the future and stuff like that. Because I read somewhere that a good CEO is not someone who can always do every job or has to do every job, but a good CEO is someone who keeps new jobs coming, new work coming, new business opportunities, more money coming into the company. So what is my goal in the future is to have people who I trust, who are as thirsty and hungry for this as I am, and really put them in positions to win, put them in positions that are gonna benefit the team. So me as the CEO, if I need someone to do my clothing orders, I will have someone do that, and I will think of new ways to make that run smoother, new ways to bring in more money, new ways to bring in more clients, bring better value, and constantly be on the hunt for all this stuff while the work's still getting done, if that makes any sense. So planning. I plan here, I plan on that calendar, I plan on my book, I plan on my 3 laptops that sit there all the time. I plan on, if you look over here, I have even my whiteboard over here that I got shit planned on. There's shit going all over the place. There's even books here that have planning and schoolwork in them, and it's just insane, man. So the amount of planning I find is crucial. I can't stress this enough, and that's why I'm spending a little bit more time talking about the planning side, because it is so crucial. Yeah, man. That's another huge key, in my opinion, to running a successful business is planning. But enough of that, back to the eats. Lego. What up, guys? Welcome back to the vlog. Right now, it's Summer Shredding episode 4, coming at you live. I'm getting ready for the gym right now. Tegan's coming to pick me up. Then we're going to Garden City. Good life. Lego. Welcome back. Just finished editing this week's vlog. Summer Shredding episode 3. It's going live in 2 days on Monday. So right now it's Saturday. Finish the edit, it's just mixing down. It takes forever and a day to goddamn export now that I got the higher quality camera, higher quality videos, but it's worth it. So, whatever. I should probably get ready for the gym before she gets here. Lego. Whew, it's cold outside today. Actually, you know what? It's not that bad compared to the last couple days, to be honest, so I shouldn't complain. Let's just see if my truck has trouble starting. Usually that doesn't, but... Ooh, yep, that sounds cold. That sounds cold. It was nice and sunny. Ooh, that's crisp. Gotta love it. What time is it? 9:52? 9:52 a.m. Sunday morning. Going to Wally World. Gonna get some food for summer shredding. I'm bringing you guys along to show you, because last week I showed you guys exactly what I eat, but since then, since doing my full day of eating, I have changed the goal, because right now my major goal is not to be a professional bodybuilder. It's not even really to be in bodybuilding. My main goal is to just have a great physique, great body that can last me a lifetime, that is functional, that is healthy. So that's kind of where I'm at. I've done the whole bodybuilding thing so I can experience it, know what it's about, and have clients come to me, and I actually have that life experience and I've done it. So I've walked the walk as much as I can talk the talk, is if you want to put it like that. So I wanted to experience it for myself. That being said, it's not my favorite thing to get up on stage and, like, sure, I don't mind the whole shorts and everything. Like, I was in the smaller shorts, the classic physique. I honestly, man, don't mind being on stage like that. It's just, I don't see how being in the gym and growing and getting huge and then I have to dance around and do all this stuff. Like, it's cool to watch, but it's just not my thing. Respect to anyone who does it, because that shit is hard as fuck. It takes some real gonads, and, like, it is one of the toughest things I've ever done in my life, is diet for that long and then go actually do the show. It takes some fucking nuts and a lot of fucking time. So kudos to anyone that is hardcore with that shit, anyone who's starting it, anyone who does that, period. That is hardcore shit. It's just not my shit. So what me and my friend have decided to do is, instead of doing the show, we are gonna do a Spartan race. I've done one before in the past, a couple of years back, and my God, man, it was fucking phenomenal. It was insane. Probably one of the most rewarding feelings I've ever felt, crossing that finish line, because it not only takes strength, it takes endurance, it takes grit, it takes everything mentally out of you, everything physically out of you, and it pushes you to the brink of, like, snapping so many times because you're running so far. You're going through so many obstacles, water, trees, bush, sand, hills. You know, you gotta carry heavy objects and swim across saw stuff. It's just gnarly as fuck, and it's something that anyone should be proud of to compete. There's a few people I know from Winnipeg who are actually insanely good and, like, sponsored by Reebok and do this shit all the time. So shout out Mick Fit on the Instagram, Mick_Fit. Dude's a beast. Like, guy's insane. Follow him if you don't. He's crazy, man. Super cool dude. Gonna hopefully run into him out in Alberta. I'm gonna be at that race and he's gonna be there, so I'm pretty pumped to see that. So that's the gist. Right now we're going to Walmart. I'm just trying to talk to you guys when my truck warms up. Woo, it's fucking cold, man. And I got the heat on the cold side. Great. All right, well, I'm going to start my journey to Wally World to show you guys exactly what I'm going to be eating now. This car is just horrible. So anyone that really knows me knows that I have a very broad music spectrum range that I love. I bought an album today at Walmart. It was on sale, super cheap. It was like 15 bucks, and I shouldn't say super cheap, I guess 15 bucks still, but I'll show you when I get home and unpack it, because I used to DJ and stuff, so I used to have turntables, so I got a shit ton of vinyl. I used to make beats too off of vinyl, like the old school way onto an MPC, so I have like a dick ton of vinyl at my parents' place still in their basement. So I'm house sitting them this week, so I'll be going through it. So it made me think, okay, I should have my turntables, which I don't have anymore, but my brother-in-law for Christmas bought me this little one. It's like a briefcase and it's got the speakers all on set, and you got the turntable on top so you can listen to vinyl. So I haven't been able to try it yet because all my vinyls are at my parents' place. I know I'll be there this week, but I can't wait. All right, so we're cooking now. I have to come grab my egg whites. Ready to cook. Cha-ching. Boom. Oven's preheated. Pan on. Set you guys up here so you can see what the frog is going on.
Got the chicken. Got it dressed. Slide it. Set this timer. Probably for like
warm and toasty. Gonna take your attention over here to this thing. All right, we got some egg whites and spinach. Foist. Why am I sucking so hard at egg cracking lately? Like, it's a real problem for me lately. Come on.
Come on, get out. Get out of my shell. Get out of the shell.
That's the, like, look at that. That's horrible. Bam, baby. Crack eggs in a single freaking whip.
Might as well do it with the red.
That's kind of better, I guess, for the most part. So you guys can see me a little bit more. So right now, guys, what we got going on is I am cooking my breakfast. Show you guys a little bit of my scrambled eggs and spinach with egg whites, three large eggs. That's gonna be my breakfast today. I'm also gonna cook up, where's the light? I'm also gonna cook up some ground beef, some extra lean ground beef. Got two tubes, some chicken cooking. There's about 12 and a half minutes left right now until it's done, and then I gotta flip it because I flip my chicken, so it's juicy as fuck. Do some reps up work for the next line, some promo work for the line coming out, the collection, the Evolve collection, and then I'm gonna, well, I eat my breakfast and then I'm gonna just wait for this shit to cook. And then I got the gym at 4 o'clock with K-Fed, my good bro, K-Fed, and then I have, we're going back to his place. Girlfriends are, well, my girlfriend and his wife are coming there because obviously she lives there. So we're gonna go there, hang out for the night and chill, kick it, do what we do. So right now I'm gonna get back to cooking and eating because I'm starving as fuck. Let's go.
Working on a weekend like usual. Way off in the deep end like usual. Niggas swear they passed us, they doing too much. Haven't done my taxes, I'm too turned up. Virgil got a paddock on my wrist going nuts. Niggas caught me slipping once, okay, so what? Someone hit your block up, I tell you if it was us. Man, a house in Rosewood, this shit too plush.